So in this video, we will discuss some more additional features of Report Studio. So far we have covered creating simple reports, creating charts, how to add totals. So let's get into some more neat stuff. So let's talk about filters. So here, as you see this this funnel shape with a yellow color, this is called a filter. So as probably the name mention name signifies, filter allows you to create a filter for the report. So we can use this, or we can use the query to create a filter. So for example, we get the query and so here, as you see, here we have a detailed filter. So let's say we want to create a filter for where total sales amount or sales amount is greater than, you know, $5,000. So here we drag this one here. Actually, you have to drag from the So let's cancel this one. Okay, so let's drag it from, you should drag it from here, not from, so sell amount. Okay, so we, it's greater than 10,000. Maybe let's say 5,000. So now we created a filter, and see here is our expression. And if we run the report, you'll see only more than 5,000 sales amount is showing up. I think there was a little problem with creating the filter, but let's here you see a report without the filter, and see our field is an aggregated sell amount, right? And we have so 16,000, 19,000 and 66,000. So let's create a filter where we want to filter out this row, which is 66,000. So let's create a filter where we say that the aggregate sell amount is less than maybe 50,000. So with that, let's create a filter. So this is our aggregate sale amount. So let's put it here. And then we say this is less than 50,000. So, and now let's run the report. Okay, coming back to the sales, the filter here, as you see, we have defined filter with sales amount greater than 10,000. Now let's run the report. So since we have in our report, we have let's get our report designer here. So here we are displaying each and every transaction because we have added the quarter also. So we will group it by the quarter, and we'll display only the transactions which would have the amount greater than 10,000. So let's, just for clarity, let's get the let's add the date also here. Sale date. Okay. So let's run the report. Okay, so so as you see, all our sales amount are greater than 10,000. Okay, so that shows the filter is effective. Okay, so now let's talk about another feature called prompts. Now, for always, you know, some reports where when it runs, it should ask the end user something. So now I'll show you how to create prompts. So for example, let's say we want to, when we run the report, we want user to enter the quarter. So to get started, again, you choose the toolbox, and then there is something called value prompt. So which is here. So let's add a value prompt here. So we want to add it underneath. Okay. So now the way the value prompt works is it creates, first to create a prompt, you have to create a parameter. So let's say parameter name is quarter. So as if, think about it as if, you know, you are passing a parameter to the report. Now if you had already had some already defined parameters, then you could have used that. So let's say this is quarter. And then, now the way Cognos works is that for parameters, it creates a drop down with the existing parameters. So to create the drop down, we have to tell Cognos that what value it should, what field it should take. So in our case, it is quarter name. Okay, so the operator is equals to, so that means we want, when they enter quarter equal to 4, then we want the report to get the results where quarter equals to what the value entered. So this is parameter. So now do next, and the values to display again is okay. So this is applied to query 1, and the values to display again is quarter. So what that means is that sometimes you, if you have you know, some sort of ID and description field, then you can use an ID column to filter, but to display you know, a different column. So it's something like when you fill up a form in the web and you have a drop down, and internally it create it, you know, when, even though you see the string or a descriptive value, but internally it's basically stores the ID or submits the ID when you do a form submit. So something along those lines. So values to use is basically the ID, and the values to display is the name. So let's finish it, and we can call it query quarter. So this is, see why it is a query, because Cognos internally defines a query to build up that drop-down form. So once we create it, okay, so now if we run it, you will be a little bit more clear. Okay, before we run it, I think I forgot to do something. So this is the properties of our parameter. Now there's something called auto submit. This one you have to set it to yes. Okay. This one, auto submit equal to yes. So these will enable, when you choose a parameter from the drop down, it will automatically, you don't have to press OK or anything, it will automatically filter out the results. So I think we got pretty much everything. So let's run it. Okay, so we say finish, which will kick off the report. So as you see here, provide a value here. We have to now see Cognos has built up this drop down using the query quarter which you have defined. So let's say we want to choose query quarter, and then we hit OK. So as you see, we have only quarter 2 results. Now if we put quarter 1, it will give quarter 1 results. Now because we have some did auto submit equal to yes, that's why it displays the results. If you had not defined auto submit equal to yes, then you would not have been seeing the results. So that's the way you define prompts. So I think in this video we talked about filters, we talked about prompts. Just to recap, prompts, you have prompts is associated with a query and also a parameter, and you can and then you're familiar with already with aggregates, and I think there are a few more things, and with that we will pretty much wrap up the report studio.